This is like part number four of the 410 brass shotgun shells. I have a couple corrections that I ran across. I mentioned in a previous video that I did not have to resize the brass, but I was having some difficulty fitting the brass back in some of the chambers of the Magnum Research BFR pistol. So simply what I did, and it was all in the upper right here. The bottom is fitting fine. Two different ways that I attempted to do it. I don't know if you can see that in the video, that line around the top. I put that into the bottom of a 44 Magnum die, and that was sufficient to bring it in, so they just slide in now. But it worked it just a hair too much, I believe. So this one has been sized. I simply took my 308 Winchester die, pulled the pin. You can leave the pin in if you don't have anything in, and insert it up to there. That is that line that is made from the chamber of the BFR, going from 45 Colt coming down to the 410 sight. Like I said, this all fits fine. It was just up here at the neck. So this is giving it simply a little more of a taper. So resized all of these. Okay. That unique powder I was using, boy, that was some smoky stuff. So I have some accurate number 9 that I was loading 45 Colt shooting 300 grain XTP bullets. My loading manual, that was the only powder it showed for that particular load, so I bought some. Since then, I've worked up some loads for the 410, kind of a pet loading that I have. So what we have, 18 grains of the accurate number 9. Once again, work up your own. This isn't for a judge. I haven't tried it in a my break open 410. This is simply for the BFR, the Magnum Research. It can take some abuse, and I know that, so that's why I'm doing what I am here. Be safe, everyone. So here's my 18 grains. I put them in. Now, I did get some nitro cards and from fiber cushions from Ballistic Products to test them out, because I've been using my cardboard discs, and boy, is that a chore, cutting all these babies up. What I did find, even by getting their 0.43 caliber as opposed to the 0.41 caliber, it's still too small. Drops right away. Push it down. I marked this deal so I know if I'm have too much powder in, not enough powder. Then I'm utilizing my over card to get that good seal that you need. Getting that over. Or two. Up to there. My next deal, I'm taking a fiber cushion. I am peeling about that much off of it. Drop it in my fiber cushion. And then I have two 45 caliber balls. They're actually 0.445, and they're still just a hair too big. I need more like a 0.43. But, so all I did, if you can see the ring around it, I swayed them down in the butt end of my 7.62x39. Jam up there, tap back out. So, dropping in my balls. Pop two of them in there. Take another top card. Bada bing. It's an awesome load. Try to get some video to attach to the back of this. Oh, don't forget your nail polish. Holds it in real well. Lots better than that Elmer's glue did. Try to get some video footage of that. Thank you.
Huh?
Bird shot. So this is the 244
caliber balls.
And you want the heater?
Yeah, I'd hit that heater thing.
Good moving.
All right.
Uh-oh.
Man, there's a lot of damn bugs.
That had to hurt somebody. Oh, yeah.
That fuck